Well, nothing says summertime like food cooked on the grill. And for Chef Barton Seaver, the grill of choice is charcoal. Take a look.
Barton Seaver is an acclaimed chef that has opened 7 successful restaurants. For him, grilling has always been something special. Early on, Barton's parents got him involved with the preparations, and the fond family memories and delicious grilled flavors still inspire him. In his new book, Where There's Smoke, Barton shares the joys of grilling with his simple techniques and succulent recipes.
Barton, welcome back to the 700 Club. Great to see you.
I'm thrilled to be back. Thanks for having me.
All right, this is the most important, might be the most important question of the summertime. Okay. Are you ready?
Yes. Bring it.
What's going to be, charcoal or gas? What do you prefer?
You know, I prefer charcoal because to me, smoke and that rustic appeal of that, sultry flavors is so much of a foundational ingredient, much the same way that cream or stock or butter is, and it just creates this platform off which everything else can
I'm so glad to hear you say that, because gas just doesn't give you that flavor at all.
Well, it can. Gas has some benefits. Certainly has the convenience of just flip it on and it's good to go. But it also, you know, there's ways to promote the smoky flavor. Just a little boat of tin foil with some wood chips in it is a great way to introduce some of that appeal. But really, when it comes down to it, charcoal is king.
It smells great. Now, how do you light the charcoal? There's a couple different ways.
Yeah, you know, there's certainly the lighter fluid, the tried, tested way.
Yeah.
I'm not a big fan of that, especially because there's such an easy method, the charcoal chimney. It's just a little bit of yesterday's news in the bottom, the charcoal on top, and what it does is it funnels all of that fuel, all of that fire, all of that air, and so it lights the charcoal, and really within about 10 minutes, you're down burned to these beautiful ashy embers, hot, just the moderate heat that you want, slow and flavorful cooking, ready to go.
Yeah, and now there's a certain way that you actually place the charcoal so you can cook a lot of different things.
Yeah, and you know, this is probably not the grill that most people will have at home, a Weber grill or a small gas grill, something like that, but what I like to do is put the coals all on one side, and that's called an indirect grilling method. Mm-hmm. And what that allows you to do is, well, control how far away from the fire you are.
Right.
You know, since the dawn of time, we've been trying to control fire and not doing a very good job of it, but we can control how far away from the fire we are.
Okay.
So a slow, soft, smoldering heat just back from the fire gives that meat, that flank steak, a slow cook on the grill, real time to absorb all those beautiful, rich flavors.
Okay, today you're gonna show us how to make multiple things on the grill all at the same time, so let's get started.
Yeah, well, that's one of the keys to grilling, is making the most of your fire. You know, most people, when they grill, they tend to just grill hamburgers. And then they have the potato salad, the macaroni salad, the watermelon. But you know, you've got all this fire, so why not use it? So we've got our flank steak that I'm just gonna put just over to the side of the
grill
here.
Definitely not on top, you're putting it way over on the side. Okay.
And what I'm gonna do is, that's gonna take 10, 15 minutes to cook or so.
Right.
That's great, have a beer, a glass of iced tea, cook some kale, which is gonna be the next thing, if you wouldn't mind passing me that.
Kale?
Yeah.
Wow, I love kale, but I've never had it on the grill.
Well, one of the things that I love about the grill is, you know, it's inherently celebratory, seasonal, social. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And when do we grill? Well, in the beautiful months, just like today.
Yeah, it's gorgeous today.
Right when all of the vegetables are at their peak. So I love throwing vegetables onto the grill.
And this looks like it has some olive oil on it.
Yep, this is just broad kale leaves, a little bit of olive oil dressed on it. Now I'm gonna put that right over the flame. And what that does is it crisps up to a beautiful burned amber char.
So it's really good. I can't wait to try that because I'm a big fan, because kale is so good for you. It's a superfood.
Absolutely. And especially, you know, when we cook vegetables, we tend to make them soft. But we like, texture and crunch. And hey, this is a great way to get your kids interested in eating their greens.
So what's next? Want to go for the chicken?
Well, we've got a couple of things that we prepared ahead of time. We got a beautiful cilantro and yogurt marinated chicken. We've got a fabulous, what I love about that is it retains the moisture and this wonderful acidity of the yogurt tenderizes the meat. And then one of my favorite things here, just fresh raw zucchini and carrots. And we tend not to think of zucchini as a raw vegetable, but when shaved super thin with a peeler, just as you would peel a carrot, as we've done, you just continue shaving down these thin ribbons, these strands of a beautiful textured vegetables, just a little bit of Parmesan cheese. It's good to go.
And then this hummus looks gorgeous.
You know, that's another one of my favorites. In terms of making best use of your fire, I take a whole butternut squash and I throw it directly on top of the charcoal.
Okay.
And the skin protects it as it chars on the outside. It picks up that smoky, wonderful tone. But then I just make a regular hummus with it, with the butternut squash flesh, peeled off of the skin. And it's a beautiful, sweet, aromatic.
But I've never had it with butternut squash. And that's what a healthy way to do it. And of course, it still has the garlic and the tahini and all the good stuff that you would find in hummus.
All the good stuff.
And this is gorgeous. I love the salad.
Yeah, this is radicchio, one of those greens you commonly see in the bagged lettuce.
Kind of bitter.
And so with it, I paired some beautiful purple plums and just a way to offset that bitterness. And we've got this wonderful flank steak. And through the magic of television, we have our flank steak cooking. But we also have one prepared. And you can see the kale just beginning to burn.
Now, is the corn
crispy.
Getting a little toasty over there?
Yeah, the corn was just over the regular heat. So that'd be great.
Okay, here we go. Yeah, I love corn. I mean, corn on the cob in summertime, you've got to have that. And a lot of people don't think about putting it on the grill.
Well, and look at that texture
beautiful.
And the color.
I know.
It's so gorgeous.
Oh, my gosh, and it smells great.
So on top of that, we've got just a little bit of, everybody butters up their corn. This is just a red pepper butter. And just small diced red peppers thrown on top, another great summer treat.
Yeah.
Just a little bit of that right on top for it to melt down.
And I'm all about butter and not margarine. Are you? I mean, I don't do margarine.
You know, I'm a butter fan.
Good.
If you're going to use something, use the tasty stuff, right?
Use the real stuff, right. Well, what can we try? We're going to try some steak?
Yeah, absolutely.
And now, is this kale is ready?
Well, this kale over here will be ready just in a minute here. So you slice up the flank steak nice and thinly. Now, I notice you don't have a knife with you. So I'll slice that up into a bite-sized piece for you.
And you said you cooked the flank steak about 10 to 15 minutes?
Yeah, and after about 8 minutes, I'll flip it over. You know, in cooking, it's a lot like driving a car. You don't steer straight by going hard left, hard right, hard left.
Yeah.
It's just slow, moderate heat, and you want to just let the heat infuse very slowly. Mm-hmm. Small adaptations to the heat. That's all you really need.
Now this looks like it's maybe medium to well. Ooh, thank you so much.
Yeah, but look at how moist it is as well. You know, that's what you're really getting. So
it could be a little bit of a salad to pair with it. This is a very big bite that I'm going to take on national TV. Here we go.
So we got that and just a little bit of the, this is a red wine reduction.
Wow.
So it becomes a beautiful, beautiful dish.
That was fabulous.
And as easy as really just, throwing something on the grill and letting it sit. So now the kale is getting beautifully crisp.
And I want to try the kale.
And you know what? This is one of those things people are, but Bart, you're burning it.
It does look like you're burning it.
Yes, precisely. I am burning it. That's what I hope to do. So I'll just give you a crispy little bit there.
Oh, it's so crispy.
You can hear it in that audible of that crispy texture. And
yeah, listen, it's like, it really dissolves right in your hands.
Yeah, and what's the one fear of most cooks when they're, hosting? It's like, what if I burn it? It's like, actually, burn it.
This is crazy good. Wow.
Isn't it? And all it took was a little bit of olive oil, just a little bit of, time on the grill.
Mm.
And get that beautiful charred crunch to it.
Wow.
And, hey, what's easier than that?
I really want to try that hummus, though. That is so beautiful.
Dig in.
It's so summery. Do we have, I haven't used my fork yet, so I'll just try a little bit. I'm not going to try it with the bread because I just really want to taste the hummus. I love butternut squash. I love butternut squash soups, and you have a lot of soups in your cookbook.
I do, especially cold soups. In this time of the summer, one of the things that's funny about grilling is when people walk
Barton,
into a party.
This is fabulous. This is almost like a dessert. This is like so much better than hummus.
Well, thanks. Well, especially cold soups. I love when people walk into the door and, you hand them a beer, you hand them a soup, all of a sudden they don't have a hand to mess with your fire.
I'm coming to your house this summer. All right, we're out of time, but this is your book. It's called Where There's Smoke. This book is so beautiful. The pictures are amazing. There's a lovely picture of your wife in here.
Thank you.
She's a lucky woman to have a cook like you as her husband. Well, Smoke, and it's available where there's smoke. It's available wherever books are sold. And we're so happy that you came back
to share
all of this.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to share this with you and your audience.